Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I am your host, Jason Turner, available for code reviews and on-site training. In this episode, I want to talk about what I think is probably the most overlooked feature from C++ 11, and I don't think I've ever done an episode about it, but when you're pushing 400 straight weeks of C++ Weekly, sometimes episodes get lost in the mix, and sometimes I have people tell me that it might be time for me to do revisited and updated episodes on previous topics. Anyhow. I will try to keep this episode quite short and to the point. The idea is that as of C++ 11, we have constructors that can call constructors. Now, there are lots of reasons to think that this code is bad and over-engineered, but it makes a point. If I want to construct an object of type S and I pass it the value 10, this is going to call this constructor that takes an int, which is going to initialize the member variable x with the value 10. If I call this constructor with no parameters, I am calling the default constructor, which calls the constructor that takes an integer, which is this constructor, which initializes the value x with this value, which is 42. And that is basically the entire point of delegating constructors. There's just so much more to it than as it appears. So let's go ahead and throw in a couple of best practices so that this episode does not end up being only 3 minutes long. If you find yourself duplicating code in a constructor, use a delegating constructor. If any constructor completes, the object has had its lifetime begin and its destructor is called. I strongly suggest at this point, instead of asking me a question about what exactly that means, you create your own example of delegating constructors and try throwing exceptions from various places and watch where and how debug statements in your constructors and destructors are called. And then the third thing is that delegating constructors can be used for advanced object lifetime management kinds of things. They can be used as utilities. So let's say, for example, we don't actually want the user of our library or of our type to be able to construct this thing directly with an integer. So we can make that integer-based constructor private. Now again, gross oversimplification, but just something to think about. If you duplicate code anywhere in your constructor, you probably want the delegating constructor, and you can create a temporary in the constructor that you delegate from and pass that value to the constructor that you delegate to, which in many cases can actually drastically simplify the way you construct your objects. Well, anyhow, that's a very short introduction to this, but one final note. Well, that's it. Thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. I hope you enjoyed this. Be sure to subscribe. I'll catch you in the next episode.